Hey, Rayo Daniel here. I hope you're having a great day and thank you for visiting my channel. In this video, we're going to be talking about custom values inside of Highlevel. Before we get started though, as usual, if you have not subscribed to my channel, you do find it valuable, please click the subscribe button. I always appreciate your support. If you are interested in signing up for Highlevel, please use my affiliate link in the description below. I do get credit for it. Thank you so much and let's get to it. Alrighty, so here we are inside of our demo account. And before we get started, I just want to cover what custom values are. Now, custom values are a little bit unique. I really haven't seen this in any other system, but Highlevel has seen a need for people to store just unique values inside of Highlevel, different pieces of information, and then being able to use that throughout Highlevel so that you can update just one piece of information at a custom value level and have it affect multiple different pieces of information inside of Highlevel. I will give you a demonstration of what this is gonna be like, so don't feel like I'm, hope I'm not losing you on this one, but let's kind of hop into it and first of all, see where custom values are inside of Highlevel. So first of all, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna go to the settings and we're gonna go down here on the left to custom values. Now, in this example, what I'm going to do is show you how you can use custom values in websites and funnels, for instance, to customize it. This, you will see how powerful it is when I get to it. I can't really explain it to you. You're going to have to see it in action to really understand how powerful it is. But one of the things I want to do is create a custom couple of custom values here that we're going to end up using inside of Highlevel. So let's go ahead and click new custom values and I'm going to put company logo. I'm just going to get that created here. It's going to ask for a value. So I'm going to come, that's why I've got two tabs here. I'm going to open this up and I'm going to come over here to our media library. Now it's nice because Highlevel allows you to have a media library where you can upload all of your images, videos, and things like that inside of Highlevel and use it. So here we're just going to use this company logo here. So I would want to click on it, right click and say get link. I can come over here and then add the value here to company logo. Now, right now I'm creating a custom value and I'm assigning it a value inside here and Highlevel is going to store that. So, excuse me, moving forward here, if I ever need to access company logo somewhere, all I need to do is locate the custom value link here and utilize it throughout Highlevel, and Highlevel will know to translate this value here into this long link that I've already stored. Okay? Now, again, I want to show you how we can utilize this. We're going to go ahead and add, well, let's add background color, and I need to find, let's just say, let's use purple. I want a purple hex color. Okay, this one will work fine, whatever this one is here. So I'm just going to copy the hex color out of this one and put this in here. Now notice what I'm doing here. If you ever use branding colors, and you actually have a hexadecimal value for those colors that you use for your background, your colors, your text, things like that, you can store all of those in Highlevel and only and use this custom value to access it. That way you never have to worry about color pickers anymore. You can just use that custom value throughout Highlevel and it will understand what color that is. So again, you can create as many of these as you want. I'm just going to do one background color. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create headline. Let's just call it headline title. Okay. And I'm going to call it my super duper offer. So that's what I'm going to put as my headline title. So now that we've created a few things here, what I want to do is hop into the funnel side, show you how we can begin utilizing these custom values. Now, what's really nice about these custom values is whenever you get these set, these custom values can actually be embedded inside of snapshots for Highlevel. So Imagine if you created all of these custom values and created these funnels and websites like we're going to do here. You can store that in a snapshot and give that or sell that away to other people, where all they have to do to customize their funnels, they don't even need to go into the funnels themselves and customize it. They just need to go to the custom values and change the background color, the headline color, the logo. All they need to do is change those values to their values, and then voila, they just appear inside of the funnel. Let me show you how that works. So here we're going to go back. We're going to go into our sites. We're going to build a new funnel real quick here. Call it just custom values. We're going to add a new step. Just call it home, for lack of a better term. And I'm going through this pretty fast. If you guys aren't familiar about the funnel or website builder, please watch my funnel and website video that I have on my channel. It goes over all of this. I'm just kind of going through this quickly. We're not going to use an existing template. I'm just going to start from scratch. So it's going to load the builder up completely blank. We're going to use a full width section. We're going to come in and add one row. We're going to come in and add a headline element. Now, here you see this headline element here. I'm going to hop back over here and I'm going to look down here at our headline title. Notice that we created one and the headline title is my super duper offer. So I'm going to copy this custom value. Then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to replace this text with the custom value. Now, the custom value right now doesn't have anything, doesn't have any attributes. So I'm going to bold it and I'm going to underline it. Okay. So that's what we have right now. So I want to do this step by step. I'm going to click save. Now, all you see right now is the custom value headline title. You don't see what the value is until it's rendered or until it's previewed. So we're going to go ahead and click on preview. And then voila. And what you have here is you've got your custom value that you created, and Highlevel translated that into what you had in the custom value. Now, just pause right here for a second. Imagine if you use the same type of information throughout all of your funnels or all of your websites. Imagine if you ever had to go through there and change it one time. Do you have 5 places to go, 20 places to go? What if you miss one spot and you don't update one of them? Well, that would kind of look unprofessional on your funnel or website, wouldn't it? So custom values are a great way where you edit it in one spot. You go to the custom value area, you edit it, and then all of the places where you have that custom value embedded get changed just like that. So perfect. So now we're going to sit back and continue. So right now this is going to be a funnel. So funnel, we're going to need to have an image. We'll throw an image in here and then we'll add a one-step order form. So we want to sit back and be cool. So right here for the image, I want to go back and use our company logo. So right now we've defined a company logo. That's the value here. I'm going to take this custom value, come back to the funnel. Now I'm going to come down here to this area where it says image. This is where you would normally browse out to your media library, select the image, and then it has a link path to this particular image. It's not what I want to do. I want to delete this and I want to put in the custom value. So when I do that, look what just happened. Isn't that amazing? Like fairy dust, magic. Boom, it just appeared. So Highlevel took that custom value, understood what it was, got the link that we gave it, and then went out and rendered that inside of here for us. So it automatically loaded the image. Now, think about that. Think about every place where you have a company logo, every place where you have some kind of other standard logo, how important this could be if you could just replace all of those so that in the future, if you ever needed to do anything with that again to replace an image, you replace it in a custom value and boom, you don't need to replace it on the 5, 10, or 50 funnels that you've got to make sure that you update the image on all of them. It could be a product. It could, keep this in mind, this could be a monthly offer. You know, maybe you change your offer every month and you want to sit back and offer something different. Well, that image every month changes to whatever the new offer is. So that would be a great way, you know, to go in and edit it once a month, change it a monthly offer, and then boom. So in the custom value headline could be May monthly offer. And then next thing you know, you change it and you change the headline to actually say June monthly offer. So you never need to come touch the funnel page again. You just need to update the custom values. And then the page, voila, it just changes automatically on the fly and everything is perfect in high level land. So let's continue. So one of the other things that we went and we did was we created a background color. So here we gave it a hex color, and I know it could be a very loud color. I probably am not going to pick something that's, you know, white or gray. It's probably going to be very bold. But inside here, if you go to settings, if you want to change the background color of the entire page, you would just simply select this background color here. And you could do an image if you want to do an image here. I'm going to select this for color. Now, I don't want to choose any of these colors. So right now, if you click on this link, it says, did not find a color, add a custom one. Okay. So now it allows us to add a particular color here. So I'm going to go here. I'm not going to put in a hex color. I'm going to put in our custom value. And I'm going to click on add color. Isn't that just amazing? How boom. You know, we just add it one time and next thing you know, the background color is completely changed because Highlevel recognized it. So right now, if we want to go ahead and save all this, click preview. Now we've got my super duper offer with the DigiGlobal logo up there, an order form, and the background color is all changed. And guess what? If we ever need to change something, we never need to come back to this page again. But let's not take my word for it. Let's do something different. Let's take this color and let's look for a red hex color. Blood red. Ooh, that's going to be a good one. Blood red color. And we're going to come back here to the background color. We're going to edit it and just simply take this color out, change it with another one, click on update. That background color gets updated. This is exactly what I've been telling you to do. You just come into your custom values, you change the color, you never have to go back to the funnel, you click on preview, and the color should come back out. Oh, looks like we're gonna have to hit a refresh. Oh, that didn't work out very well here, did it? Hey, we just had kind of a little glitch right here with the Highlevel system. Looks like we can't update the color dynamically while the funnel page is open, which is cool, fine. You just kind of have to back out of the funnel page and then reload the funnel page. And then when the funnel page reloads, it then picks up the new custom value color that you had and then changes screens and so forth here. So right now it was just sort of a display purposes, but if you take a look here, we're going to go back in and edit this. So we've got this color. This was our blood red color. Notice if we go to background, the color changes to this. So let's just test this again here. I want to make sure I definitely give you guys some great information here. So I'm going to click on edit and let's just change. Yeah, change this to, let's just say black. Give that just a minute to update. So if we come back here and we click on this and reload it, notice now that the black color is in here. And if we sit back and go to the background color, notice that the custom value changed to black. So, and then of course, if we preview, you know, we'll get the black color. But the problem is just dynamic, creating that color dynamically. Just, it takes a little bit of a delay with Highlevel, but just if you, we're going back and forth inside of the editor, which is causing some particular issues here. So just remember to close the page, reopen the page again, and then all the new colors will end up being there. So this again is just a couple of quick examples inside of funnels, how you can use custom values. Now, in this video, I'm not going to go into detail of what I'm about to tell you with custom values, but custom values also have other purposes related to third-party software systems. Specifically, you've been seeing a lot about integrating Highlevel and ChatGPT. So how do we communicate back and forth between those systems? Typically, people go through and create, if you watch the videos that they have, they create zaps between the OpenAI system and then Highlevel. Well, one of the things they use inside there is they need to have custom values. So a custom value is, again, a placeholder where the information either could be the request going to ChatGPT or the request coming from ChatGPT that the Zap puts back into Highlevel, and then you use that custom value to respond back to someone. That right there is again how you would use custom values inside of Highlevel. So I hope you found the video useful. Sorry about the little glitch that we had. It kind of took me a minute to figure, you know, what the refresh problem that was having inside of the funnel page here on this example. But if you found the video useful and you found it informative, click the like on it. Leave me a comment if you want to know anything else about custom values or that I didn't cover here, or just to kind of leave me a comment of how you felt about the video. I would appreciate it. Thank you so much. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not already, and you have a great day. Bye-bye. Hey, I want to thank you again for visiting my channel and give you one more little thing here. If you are interested in Highlevel and getting some additional Highlevel training, please see the link in the description below. I do have a free course I'm offering that covers everything related to Highlevel and gives you all the information that you need to know. Thank you so much and have a great day.